We'll be bringing you an interconference matchup in this one as the Warriors take to the road. Well, what better way to spend a Monday night than with the 2K Sports team and the NBA? Welcome, everyone. This is Kevin Harlan with Greg Anthony and Doris Burke, our game analysts, and from the sideline, David Aldridge. Last time these two teams met, it was the New York Knicks picking up the loss in that outing against the Warriors.
May have been the worst effort you'll see from them all season long. Even for a game they weren't supposed to win, it should not have been that bad.
Knew it would be tough going in, but they were completely overmatched. Skill, effort, everything.
And with pregame routines coming to an end, we're just about ready for our tip-off. First, though, let's get a report from the sideline and say hello to David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, Klay Thompson continues to be happy with his role in the Warriors. He said, winning is so much fun. It's one thing to put up numbers, and it's another to sacrifice and be on the best team in the NBA. I'll take the latter every time. At the end of the day, people are going to remember championships. That's what it's all about. That's absolutely right. Kevin?
Thanks, David. That's the mindset you have to have. In the end, winning titles should be the ultimate goal. With the All-Star break now in the rearview mirror, Doris, things getting a little more serious. The screws are tightening. What will the contenders' focus be like here in the back half of the season?
You know what, Kevin? I'm curious to see which teams feel like they need to get home court advantage either through the first or second round of the playoffs, or which ones are chasing greatness and want that added edge of maybe being the overall leader in the standings, so that if there were a Game 7 in an NBA final situation, who believes that's important? But listen, championship habits are built over the long course of the NBA season. It entails preseason, camp, and the 82 games. This is going to be a fun second half.
And they can see the light at the end of the tunnel. I always thought mentally that was a big thing for these players. They can see, all right, we're close to when the games are going to be so important because they got the playoff label on them.
No doubt. No doubt, Kev.
Now a chance, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. The starting five on the floor. And Golden State looking at who they've got. It's the Splash Brothers, Curry and Klay in the backcourt. Offense and defense with Durant and Draymond at the three and the four. And it's McGee in at the center position. And so it's the Warriors getting on the board first. The 11-footer, rebounded by McGee. Thompson against Hardaway. And Thompson kicks to Curry. McGee a screen. Shot clock at five. Curry attacking. Out of hand on it. They recover. And it's going to be a 24-second shot clock violation. They turn it over. Warriors on D. They want to keep rolling here following the win against the Thunder.
Yeah, and fortunately for them, I thought the opponent's defense just never showed up.
I mean, you'd have to question their effort, Greg. They did a great job at penetrating and kicking out. The defense simply wasn't up to the task. Well, you don't get much more wide open inside the arc. He simply got to make that shot.
And Greg, with Enes Kanter last season, he had to miss significant time with the broken hand, but his offensive game is something to watch when he's healthy.
He just plays hard. He provides that instant offense off the bench, a great array of post moves to pick from. And looking at the career of Courtney Lee, you know, has hopped around from team to team a bunch of times and always a valued teammate, but just hadn't stayed on one team for very long.
Two shots.
First one falls for him. And with Lee, you know exactly what you're going to get with his defense and shooting.
And Lee is always going to be a wanted commodity. His ability to defend and shoot aren't easy to find, and you just hope he's able to kind of settle in into a long-term situation.
And he makes both free throws.
And that's the norm for him. He's pretty much automatic when he's at the line.
Curry dishes to Durant. He kicks it to Thompson. McGee is screen on Hardaway. Curry passes to McGee. Green, the screen. The drive by.
Look at that. Wow. Boy, how about the long strides of Klay Thompson? You sell out on the jumper, he puts it on the deck and drives it.
And that was Under Armour bringing you that replay. Unleash chaos. And what a play it was. McGee with the block. Now the Warriors moving it up. Durant's got the ball. That one falls. Durant's got his first bucket of the night.
And great hustle to turn that block shot into a fast break opportunity. Big time play on both ends.
Wasted no time on that one.
The efficiency of Enes Kanter is impressive. This guy's massive on the blocks and knows how to score.
Back to Curry. Launches it. Good, and it's Green picking up the assist. Curry's got six.
Well, Jeff Hornacek was chosen to be the head coach of the New York Knicks with the understanding that the triangle offense would be part of the system put in place. Now with the change in the front office, that is no longer the case, guys.
And a new group in for the Knicks. Kyle O'Quinn is checked in for Kanter. Lance Thomas comes in for Michael Beasley. Troy Williams checked in for Lee. And it's Burke in for Emmanuel Mudiay. Then for the Warriors, Pachulia. He's checked in for JaVale McGee. Iguodala comes in for Kevin Durant. And it's Livingston in for Steph Curry. Livingston, that's good. The Hornacek probably more comfortable with an up-tempo modern style. And Doris will see what he does with this new offensive freedom. Williams gets to Burke. 23 seconds left here in the opening quarter. Pass to O'Quinn. Out of bounds. Golden State takes possession.
No clue where that pass was going. That is a brutal turnover.
Livingston with it. He's averaging a bit over 5 points a game. Pick by Pachulia. Thompson for the triple. Nailed from three-point land. 5 points in the game. And so it's the Golden State Warriors holding on to an 11-point cushion as we get ready to take a break. They've been playing some ferocious defense. We've got more in store for you right after this. And certainly one of the game's bigger personalities, Draymond Green, had this to say about his approach to leadership.
Most importantly, it's just about how the guys respond to me. And, you know, just really bringing that energy and that attitude and that fire each and every night, every day, whether it's in practice, whether it's, you know, in the game, whatever it is, just always bringing that energy and that passion.
A heart and soul guy, Draymond Green, has the kind of spirit guys that everyone else can just kind of feed off of.
Yeah, his talents and contributions now being appreciated. He's forced his way into the discussion of top 10 players in our league.
And welcome back. It's been all one-sided so far through the first quarter as our second quarter gets underway. And a very convincing performance here from the Warriors so far.
I think they play great D and not giving up anything easy early on.
You love that they're making the offense work, right? Making every single thing they try to do hard.
So on the floor for Golden State to begin the second quarter. Thompson at the two with Iguodala playing the three. Pachulia is out there with West, and it's Livingston in at point guard. And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, guys, Emmanuel Mudiay spent a year in China prior to the NBA rather than playing in college. A lot of people respect what he did while he was over there. He said, being in a foreign country, everything is different. It made me mentally strong. Now in the NBA, he said, you've got to have confidence because every point guard in this league can play. You've got to keep that edge and be prepared at all times. Kevin?
Thanks, David. Mental fortitude is critical, especially when you're a young player in this league.
You know, it seems a little to me like the mystique of this building that the Knicks call home can be overwhelming at times, right? So many great games played here, perhaps the most iconic floor in all the NBA.
Here is Livingston following the score by New York. Iguodala with it. Williams picks him up. Clock is at three. Off the screen. Again, Golden State.
You know, the assist has to go to the screen on that play. Gave him all the room he needed to rise and fire.
And with this mecca of basketball, there certainly have been more than a few incredible moments that played out in front of these fans. Doris, growing up a Knicks fan as you have, what great moments stick out to you most in this terrific building?
Well, there's so many to choose from, whether it was Allen Houston's floater in the lane, Willis Reed coming out of the tunnel to play in Game 7, or, of course, Patrick Ewing leading the Knicks to the NBA Finals in 1994.
Yeah, it looked like they tried to shoot their way out of the slump, and that didn't work. They got to go back and regroup.
Yeah, maybe a new approach, because what they're doing is not working. You're going to have to alter some things on the offensive end.
And a whole new group out on the floor right now for the Knicks. Then for the Warriors, Green, he's checked in for Pachulia. Kevin Durant comes in for West, and it's Stephen Curry in for Thompson. It's good.
I think you always have to be looking for the man in the middle, and he finds him with a great feed that time.
Curry kicks to Green. Here's the screen, the three, and there's Stephen Curry on the assist by Green. Curry's got nine.
I love the mindset of Draymond Green. This guy is constantly on the lookout for an open teammate.
Beasley outside. The dish now to Mudiay. Back to Beasley. New York needs to get off a shot. Hardaway from outside. They get the rebound. Curry with the steal. Ball's knocked loose. 52 seconds left in the first half of the game. Mudiay kicks to Beasley. Another shot right through the D for the layup.
Defensive rebounding, just such a crucial part of the game.
I'll tell you, if you don't box out well, expect to get burned. You can't afford to give them second chance opportunities.
The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
And so here is New York. They trail by 16. Here's Lee outside. Steph Curry with the rebound. From deep, an absolute bomb from three-point range. Curry's got a couple of three-pointers in the second for the Warriors. Hardaway for three with one on the clock.
And this is why Draymond is one of the best defenders in the NBA. Constant energy, and it's absolutely infectious.
And through the first half, a pretty lopsided affair. Warriors ahead. They finish off the second quarter on a 14-6 run. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks, Kevin. Joined here by Steve Kerr. Coach, great offense from your guys in the first half. What got you the lead?
I started calling some great plays for Steph Curry.
That's why you're the coach of the year, Steve. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David, and we'll be back after halftime as the third quarter gets underway.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
The first half in the books. This is Ernie Johnson. This is Shaquille O'Neal. This is Ken Smith. Welcome back.
Ken,
as we break down the action. The first half was all about Stephen Curry. He had 14 points and one steal. Taking a look at the Warriors, Kenny, what'd you think?
In terms of their offensive performance, that was a very well-played half of basketball. Good ball movement off the ball, hard screens being set, and they found the guy for the open look. That's how they were able to shoot such a tremendous percentage from the field. With that fluid, efficient offense, they'll be tough to catch in the second half.
Shaq, what did you think about New York?
Well, they got a ton of issues to work out. Allow way too high a percentage to be shot against them. Not really showing any energy on defense. No discipline. Look at their faces, Ernie. Do they even want to be here?
And that is just about going to wrap it up as the second half is moments away. Down to Kevin Harlan and the rest of the crew.
Wow.
Welcome back to New York City. Some street art on the wall of the Canal Street subway station in Soho, south of Houston, just down the way from us. Well, we're getting back to the action now. It's been a one-team show so far. We'll see if that changes here in the third. Really an incredible game from Stephen Curry.
Well, they've done a good job of letting the game come to them, and really few forced shots here so far.
I think, Greg, we're seeing a couple things. Terrific play calling, unselfish nature, and quality shooting. That makes for good offense.
Welcome back, everyone, to the start of the second half. Big margin on our hands, but we'll see if that gap narrows down in the third and fourth quarters. Doris, with every team looking to spread the floor, get that space. Most big men are being asked to increase their range. Is the practice time going into that taking away from working, for instance, on other fundamentals that a big guy should be working on?
Here's how you know this is for real. When you hear Dwight Howard talking about the fact that this guy is going to spend an entire summer trying to develop the range because he wants to extend his playing career.
Sure.
Dwight Howard at one time was the single most dominant back-to-the-basket low post center. They surrounded him with shooters. They put him in pick and roll, and he was an absolute monster. You know what? I don't know if it'll take away from the other fundamentals for the center. I do know that the role of center has drastically changed in the NBA.
Enes Kanter is out there with Beasley. Then there's Tim Hardaway Jr. Then it's Lee, and it's Moutier in at the point guard position. They're the group for Jeff Hornacek starting the second half. Lee sets a screen for Moutier. Here's Beasley. The shot, no good. So Golden State will take it the other way.
A good board there, Kevin, but overall they're getting slightly out-rebounded.
Knicks trail by 21. Lee dishes to Beasley. Moutier passes to Kanter. And he uses the glass on the layup.
I'll tell you, Kev, they wouldn't object if all their looks were that close.
The Warriors have gone 2 of 3 from the field to start the second half. And Thompson kicks to Durant. Outside, Green. That's good, and a nice assist from Durant.
Great beginning to this second half. Now 3 for 4 from the field.
New York calls timeout. They couldn't put the pieces together, losing that last matchup with Boston.
And despite the outcome, I think they'll feel a little better about that game. There are a lot of positives that they can take away from that performance.
Well, you hope they learn from the experience, and it's a shame it had to come at the expense of a loss because they did play well enough to win.
One guy who's been getting it done so far, Stephen Curry.
Yeah, I think they've got to be talking about just guarding him a little more tightly on the perimeter or keep the ball out of his hands as much as possible, period. That's about the only way you're going to cool this guy off.
Some changes for Golden State. Pachulia, he's checked in for JaVale McGee. West comes in for Green. Young is subbed in for Kevin Durant. The Knicks shooting poorly, just 35% so far. And in terms of just how explosive this Warriors team can be, they can get hot over a course of a few minutes. And Doris just put a team away. The way they can shoot from deep and then play defense is just overwhelming.
How often have we seen, Kev, the game might be a 2 or 3 possession game, and within seconds, all of a sudden, they're up 20. They're incredibly deep shooting. Their ability to play off their own made shots and build momentum can steamroll a team.
Now Kanter. After the missed three from Stephen Curry, Kanter uses the glass to finish the layup. Kanter's got 6 in the quarter.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
West outside. Young from outside hits the 3-point bomb. Young's got his first 3 points of the game.
Yeah, that's too good a look to give them from behind the arc.
Burke dishes to Kanter. Second chance shot, and he sinks the layup. Kanter's got 10 points.
And after an abysmal first half from the field, the shot's now starting to fall.
The baseline J, and it's Golden State with another.
Well, Klay Thompson can score at all three levels, doing work in the mid-range right now.
picked by O'Quinn. And that one is hammered home.
And ran his man straight into the screen and got a clear path to the bucket.
That is how it is done.
Great teamwork. That's something you develop by practicing it over and over again.
He has created some terrific opportunities for himself and really made the most of them.
The feed to Cantor. Wing shot on the way. Lands soft on the front of the rim and drops. 12 points for him.
Enes Kanter is a natural-born scorer. Either back to the basket with the jumper or the post move. He's got it all.
And so it's the Golden State Warriors taking a 19-point lead into the break. The scoring has been tremendous, and they are shooting lights out with very high accuracy. And we'll be back with you shortly. And a moment ago, inside the huddle with head coach Steve Kerr.
Right now is when we go, good shot, great shot, right? Right now is when we talk on every screen down here and switch and ice and all the stuff we do.
That's Steve Kerr. This is what his teams do. They take away a lot of easy shots, easy baskets.
Yeah, you heard him. Ice the screens. Communicate. Give me everything you've got defensively.
And we're getting underway here in the fourth quarter. The scoreboard tells the story in this matchup, but we'll see how much things change up here. And Golden State looking at who they've got. It's the core of the Warriors out there with Curry, Klay, Iguodala, KD, and Draymond. Doris, much to the chagrin of basketball purists, we're seeing the near extinction of the mid-range game. Is there a way to reverse this trend?
Kevin, I don't know that we're seeing the extinction of it, and I would point directly to the finals MVP, Kevin Durant, because if you look at some of his success, it is directly in the mid-range. Russell Westbrook has some effect in the mid-range. I mean, listen, certainly the priority is on layup and three, but I don't think we've seen the extinction of the mid-range. I think this is a cyclical type of situation in the NBA, very much the way we've gone away from a low post center. Would a player that's a next level, next generation kind of player change our thinking about that? Let's see. The game is always in a constant state of evolution.
He gets that one. Cantor's got 12 points here in the second half. Hey, Doris, with all the switching on defense, it seems like everyone has to be able to guard both inside and on the perimeter. Do you see us becoming even more of a positionless league?
You know, this is a fascinating aspect to me because you focus on a player like Draymond Green, who coming out of Michigan State was considered a tweener, somebody who was neither a guard nor a forward and didn't have the requisite skill set to be effective in the NBA. But there is true value to players, be it at the small forward, the power forward, or the center position. Because the league is such a heavy pick and roll, because the floor is so spread, Kevin, the guys who have the kind of lateral mobility and the basketball IQ to switch onto smaller players and stay in front and contest shots, they're crucial. For right now, this is the trend, and I don't see it going anywhere anytime soon.
And that one comes up a bit short.
Man, with the defense laying off him, you know he's going to pull the trigger. They're lucky he didn't burn him.
Hardaway passes to Beasley. There's Lee with the three. Gets the three-pointer to fall.
Well, this is the classic 3-and-D guy, right? Lee just taking care of his role.
Timeout called the Warriors. They're leading by 15. 1:37 left in the fourth quarter. Presentation of our Jordan player of the game, Steph Curry.
And Kevin, his three-point shooting has been a big key. 12 of his points have come from downtown.
And those points didn't come cheaply. He's worked hard on the perimeter aspect of his game and got good high percentage shots.
And as the star of this team, he knows he's going to be the object of the crowd's anger. Emmanuel Mudiay is checked in for New York. The Warriors also with a sub. JaVale McGee's checked in for Andre Iguodala. Green the screen. And Thompson kicks to Curry. Edwards on the subject of league expansion. Commissioner Silver has said the 30 teams feels about right at this point. How long do you think it's going to be before we add another franchise or two to the NBA?
Right. Let me just say that I completely concur with Commissioner Silver. The last thing we want to see when the NBA is at its peak in popularity is expansion that might dilute some of the competitiveness that we want to see happen. The bigger question right now is these super team issues. Are we at a point where there is such disparity between the best teams in the league and the worst? Let's address that first, and then we can look at expansion down the road.
So you do not like the super team aspect that we're beginning to see formulate it from time to time?
I don't necessarily want to say that. I think the jury is still out, Kevin. We have to see how the next 2 or 3 years plays out as it relates to both Cleveland and Golden State. I think there was a period in the 80s where it felt like it was the Lakers and the Celtics every year. Let's not overreact, but certainly let's not add teams before we make sure we are where we need to be from a competitiveness standpoint.
Yeah, easy call.
Shooting for Golden State, JaVale McGee. Two shots.
Take a break. Two shots.
That's good from McGee. Off on that one, so he goes 1 for 2 at the line. And here are the Knicks now. Here's Ntilikina. Thomas, that's good.
Well, this guy known for terrific shot selection. Thomas getting that one to go from high percentage range.
So we see the Warriors taking the game here. This crowd was stunned by the manner in which their team was dismantled.
You know what? Shocking. I don't care what the matchup is. You never expect a road team to come in and just cruise to the kind of win they did tonight.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Clay, what is the key to the way you play tonight?
Well, I'm just used to the pace of the game by now, and my teammates do a good job of finding me when I'm open, so all credit goes to them. I just catch and fire when I'm open.
And they found the shooter, and he shot. Thanks, Clay. Back to you, Kevin.
David, thank you as always. And that'll do it, folks. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. See you next time.